Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today I have a different video for you all. It is going to be a top foundations for pale skin video. Now I am naturally very, very pale, comes from genetics and not going outside very much. So I do have a little bit of fake tan on at the moment, so sorry about that, but I am a lot paler than this naturally. So just for reference, if I am at my palest, then if I put NC15 on my face, it's too dark for me. So yeah, these are just foundations that I've found over the years of my life that I've been wearing makeup, of foundations that match me when I am that little bit light or pale, when I am pale. You know what I'm trying to say. So yeah, a lot of people have been asking me on Instagram, like, what are good foundations for pale people, pale skin tones and so forth. So I'm just going to share with you an array of foundations that I have found to cater for lighter skin tones. Now, some of these foundations are not my favorite, but again, these are personal preferences. I am recommending these foundations based on color, not so much formula. Obviously, if the foundation is completely and utterly shit, I'm not going to include it in this video if I think that. But all these foundations I do think are nice. Some of them I do favor more than others, but in general, I do think these are nice foundations. So obviously you need to, like, everything is a bit of a gamble with makeup. You're always like, is it gonna work for me? It might have worked for this person. It's not gonna work for me. I don't know. But I am gonna share with you the foundations that I personally like to wear when I am at my palest. So yeah, let's just get started. I'll start off with a drugstore one. As you can see, I really, really like this one. It's actually quite surprising how much I've actually used, considering I have so many foundations. That does say a lot. I really, really like this foundation. This is the Max Factor Facefinity All Day Flawless Foundation. This one in specific is in the shade Crystal Beige number 33. Now, this is exactly the same as the CoverGirl Outlast Day Flawless or whatever it is, the one with the blue teal pump. It's exactly the same, but the Max Factor ones are more yellow based. Now, this one is really, really nice and it matches my pale skin very, very well. It is decent coverage and it is buildable and I really, really, really do enjoy it. If you have wanted to try the CoverGirl Outlast foundation and you haven't been able to find your right match, definitely give this one a go. This one here retails for about $33 to $35, but you can always pick it up on sale because, yeah. Okay, so the next foundation is the Kat Von D Tattoo Locket Foundation. This one I have in the shade number 45. Don't let the number scare you. I think the lowest number is 42. 42 is very, 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 very pale and very white. I'm not that white, but this one does match me quite nicely. So, yeah, and this is extremely full coverage. Extremely, extremely, extremely full coverage. So if you want full coverage, if you want long lasting, this is a foundation for you. It doesn't even break down through my oils. Like, my nose will be oily as anything and I will literally grab a tissue and it will absorb all the oil, not even a blotting paper, like an actual tissue. And I just put it on my nose and no joke, only oil came off, no foundation came off. It was so weird, but so good. I really, really like that one. And that one doesn't have any SPN. And this doesn't have any SPF in it, I don't think. So that'd be great for photos if you're wanting to do that. And just quickly, back to the Max Factor one, this does have SPF 20. Okay, so next foundation, it is a very, very pricey foundation, but a little bit of it does go a long way. So this is the Chanel Perfection Lumiere foundation in the shade 10 Beige, again, for yellow undertones that are very, very pale. I do find that with this foundation, it doesn't look very good if you mix it. In regards to photos, it does look orange. Like, I tried mixing it with a few foundations, not just one type, like a few. Even I tried to mix it with another Chanel foundation, and in photos, it just looks orange. So don't get this if you're looking at mixing your foundations. It just doesn't do very well, but it does have SPF 10 and it does come with a pump, which you would expect if you're paying almost $90 for a foundation. I think this is $86. You'll notice a trend with these foundations. They are for the yellow undertones. I do have yellow undertones. I should have mentioned that at the start. So if you are of pink undertones, I'm sorry, but yeah, So the next one is L'Oreal True Match. This I used to swear by back in the day. It is still a nice foundation. I just don't reach for it as much because I have a lot of foundation, if you haven't noticed. So this one I have in the shade W1. This is the lightest shade that it comes in. It's called Golden Ivory, if that's of any help to anybody. It has SPF 17. It gives nice medium buildable coverage, which I appreciate. And it does look quite luminous on the skin as well. So yeah, that's a nice one. So Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus. I like this one. It is very, very nice. I don't think it keeps me as matte as what I would like, but it is still a nice foundation. I have mine in the shade 20. There is one lighter than this. It does look very, very pink in the bottle. I was terrified when I got this, but it is definitely more of a yellow base than a pink base, for sure. And yeah, it just gives nice medium buildable coverage. NARS SheGlow. Now, I did have to buy the pump. The pump you have to buy separately, which sucks, but whatever. What do you do? I have mine in shade Mount Blanc, which is definitely more on the pink side. But they do have a shade called Serbia. I did get a sample of that recently, and I do like the color of that. I love the formula of SheGlow, but the color that I own Mount Blanc and DeVille. I don't really like either of those shades, to be fair. But I really, really do like Serbia. So I love the formula, just the ones that I own are shit. I got matched wrong twice. Nah. But I really, really like the shade Serbia. If you are looking for a more yellow-based foundation from NARS SheGlow. Again, it is very, very light. Ha! This is probably one of my most favorite foundations of the moment that I've been wanting to try for the longest time. This is the Makeup Forever HD Foundation. I have mine in the shade N117, so it's supposed to be more on the neutral side, but it's definitely more on the yellow side to me at least. Yeah, it just gives amazing medium buildable coverage, which I love. I love medium buildable coverage. It's just my thing. I really, really like it. It's really, really good. I have first impressions on this. If I have any first impressions on these foundations, I will link them down below. And some of them I do have coming up, I know that, but I don't know if this video will be up or the first impression will be up. I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, so that's that one. I really, really, really do enjoy it, and it does come with a pump. So the reason why I did mention so many, or I am mentioning so many, is because everyone has different skin tones. So I'm trying to, skin types, sorry, not tones, this is targeted towards pale people like myself. Yeah, the reason why I'm doing that is because everyone has different skin types. So how can I recommend foundations that only suit me or are great for me if like I'm trying to actually target a certain type of skin tone? So this video is more targeting skin tone, not skin type. So hopefully with telling you about the actual foundations, you can get samples and stuff, because I know Priceline gives foundation samples. I saw this chick get like 5 foundation samples from Priceline. I was like, what? Priceline gives foundation samples? What? So yeah, I hope that made sense. Anyway, let's carry on. This one I love. This is the Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation. I've literally used it so much that the writing's rubbing off. You can't even see it properly anymore. But I have mine in shade 51. Not all Bourjois counters in Australia have the shade 51. You can get it off ASOS. And larger Bourjois stands do have the shade 51. It smells amazing. Like, I just want to eat it. It smells so good. It smells like fruit. And yeah, it's really, really nice. I don't think it lives up to its 16-hour claim, but it is a very, very nice foundation. I do have first impressions of it down below. This is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation in the shade, or full coverage foundation rather, in the shade, Fair Sand. It's like written in black on like brown cardboard. It's like as if that's not hard to read at all, right? But yeah, I really, really like this foundation. It's definitely more of a mousse than anything else. It doesn't give full coverage, I think. It definitely does give medium coverage. But it is definitely a nice consistency, which I do like having on my skin. And it is very, very quick and very, very easy to blend out as well. I'm just like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do, and it's done. It's good. It's really, really nice. And I like how it has a squeeze tube and it has 50ml. So it has way more than any other foundation that I've just recommended to you guys. And Lucky Lucky Last, this is a little bit darker than normal, but it's definitely not as dark as NC15. This is the L'Oreal Magic Lumi Foundation in the shade N1. Now this is a little bit off for me, but it might match someone. So I do want to put it out there, this is a very, very nice foundation. It is a little bit pricey for drugstore. Like, again, L'Oreal foundations are quite expensive. It's still around the $32 mark, but you can always get L'Oreal on sale. So definitely wait out for a sale. But I do like this foundation. It's super, super light on the skin, but it gives good coverage. So yeah, I would recommend that one also. Okay guys, so that's all the foundations that I had to share with you that I have in my collection that I think are decent. If I put a foundation on my face and I'm like, this is terrible, I didn't include it in here, like that wasn't what I was getting across. Some foundations I'm like, I don't think it works good for my skin, but it would work amazing for other skins. So all the foundations that I've included here, I would either recommend or I do personally use. I wasn't really going for skin type. I was definitely going for more skin tone with this video. So I hope you guys understood that, and I hope it wasn't a waste of time and for you and all that stuff. I hope it was helpful. Like, I hope it was helpful. Like, if I've helped one person, I will be happy. If you are pale, comment down below what foundations you use so I can definitely check them out for when I'm pale as well. Yeah, I think that's the end of my video. I don't think I have anything else to say. Yeah, if you like these videos, definitely give it a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments. And I hope you're having a wonderful day. I will see you next time. Bye.